Alrighty, people. I'm still up in Maine, and I am going to be picking up three vehicles from this recovery lot. That GMC Sierra, Toyota RAV4, and the Subaru Outback up there. So, but he's got to clean that out and then drop it, and then I can get my truck and trailer in the proper location. I hit the easy button on the Sierra because it is drivable, has keys and runs, but the other two don't have keys. So that being said, I wonder, well, I don't want to like set you guys there, so I'm going to move the truck. Because I want to put the Subaru on first, which is awesome. But if he's going to actually set it on backwards, or set it down right there backwards, so I can put it up backwards, it's perfect. I couldn't have asked for a better situation right now, other than maybe the car's having keys. But Subaru and the RAV4 don't have keys. But the wheels on the RAV4 are somewhat straight. The wheels on the Subaru are somewhat straight. So that is a good thing. And there's a trailer. I don't know what he's doing here. Might be the owner. Who knows? We'll see. Knocking the camera over, it would be nice. get the winch remote. Sorry whoever owned this car before, but hot out here. Thank you. on this thing. Out. Reposition the winch. Yep. So I can turn that car sideways a little bit. brilliant noise. Take the snatch block off. We'll hopefully just pull it straight up. And there goes the remote on the ground. I'll leave the snatch block up here where I can get to it. Further, hopefully it will be on the trailer up top before I need to move the front end sideways. Let's move this. Too far over that away. The front end is still the whole car is climbing that way because I have the winch on this side. Alright, so let's put the winch on this side. The underside of cock. Maybe I should just do it straight. Need to move it that way. All right. Get up there, get the snatch lock back on here. So I slide the rear end back that way. Maybe. What I think I'm going to do is just winch it up further, put the snatch block over there in the corner, so as it's pulling up, it should veer to that way. you're soon gonna hit my car. Pain in the butt. Imagine that the winch is being a kind of pain in the butt. A little bit. worth it. strap this down and then line up with the RAV4. After I put another battery in the camera. Take a drink. Alright, I'm gonna let you guys sit over here and watch me from afar. Subaru down. Is there anything metal on this thing? big parking breakers on. Parking brake, that's on. I got a finger up how to get off. And the old car is just going that way. Odessa has a forklift. So steering back to that side. I'm gonna get the front wheels up and then move the freaking damn thing again. everything's worth a shot, isn't it? Make life easier. Didn't work. So we'll figure that up on the trailer. And we'll figure out how to manually release that parking brake. J-hooks. Haven't used them in forever. Haven't used J-hooks in forever. What did I do with the remote? Where's the remote, guys? Toolbox, but that way I can just pull straight. is straight. And we're in that way. Now, we're going to try my J-hook. Essentially, these J hooks are for exactly what I'm going to do. Make a lot of noise. So I'm just going to pull. In theory, this should just come up straight. That's in theory. We should put it in park. Put it in park so those tires will not rotate. See what my theory is. Freaking things that the ramps are getting pushed up. to do is just get this these ramps to not move. Yes.
Give this ass end a push over here.
Okay. button. Yeah. That one runs.
Let's just keep going. Looks like we got something going on.
Yeah. I mean, winch. Hopefully the winch won't get out. I think you don't have to push it anymore.
No.
Even now. And then once I get it up there, then I can get up under it. car is finally up there. I just got to get in there and figure out how to take that thing off, the parking brake off. And drive that car truck onto the trailer. All right, I'm done. I'm turning you guys off. Till next time. All right, peoples. I just wanted to let you get an update. Yes, I ended up finally getting the RAV4 on the trailer with the parking brake engaged. No key. But since it was up here and I had full access to the rear wheels inside, this morning I rolled the truck back a little bit in order to get better ability of getting in here. But I'll let you see. Maybe I can't. Two screws, hex head, don't remember what size. Take that off, and then all you gotta do, it's right in there somewhere. It's hard to see. But then you take the Torx bit and untwist the piston. And she comes loose. So right now, parking brake is no longer on this car. So I'll be able to roll it right off with no problems. I should have jacked it up and done that before loading so it would be easier to load. But really, I didn't think it was going to take that much time to drag it up onto the trailer, but it did. And that car alone took an hour and a half. I was at that recovery lot for 3 hours loading 3 cars. So, I just wish there was an easy way to unlock the steering wheel. Gotta figure that out, because that will make life a lot easier. Alright, now I'm heading to Odessa in Boston.